everyone. In this video, I'm going to show you how to do a literature search in one of our other databases called Web of Science. It has some interesting features that our other resources don't have, so it makes a good supplement to searching in the ones I've showed you in previous videos like PubMed, Embase, and Cochrane Library. Similar to our other resources, you want to make sure you get started on the Medical Library homepage and then choose Library Resources. You can then type Web of Science into the search box and click Apply. And you'll notice if you scroll down, here's the link to Web of Science. Remember, if you're off campus, you'll see a screen asking you to sign in via Open Athens. You want to choose Florida Atlantic University, and you will sign in with your FAU NetID and password. I've already done this, so let me show you what will happen once you're logged into Web of Science. In this database, it can work very similar to the other databases that you're probably used to, like PubMed and Embase. You could type in a keyword for your topic here. You could add rows. If you have your PICO elements, you could put each of your PICO elements in each box. But what I want to show you today is a little bit different, and I want to show you some of the interesting and extensive features of this database. So some of you on your research projects might be working with the NHANES data set. So I thought you might be interested to see how that data set has been used and how people have been publishing in it, where they've been publishing, in case you are still trying to think about what research question you might want to ask, or you just want to see what research has been done with the data set. So what I've done in the search box is I've typed in NHANES, and I'm going to click search. And similar to most of the other resources you've seen, it's pulling up articles from this list of journals. And right now it's sorted by relevance. You can refine your results using these options on the left. Like if you want to see the most recent articles that were published using this data set, you could limit by year. There's lots of different ways you can limit over here on the left. But something that is pretty specific to Web of Science that you can't do in many other places is you can also sort the articles by the number of times they've been cited. So if I click where it says relevance and change it to citations highest first, this article would be older. It's from 2009. But since this article was written and it did use some research studies, including the data set that we're talking about, it's been cited 13,000 times. So it's an interesting way to see the articles that have gotten the most citations. Like I mentioned, they'll be older because it takes time for articles to get cited, but can give you an idea of what were the most influential articles on a topic. Similar to other databases, if you want to actually get to an article, you click on this Find It at FAU button to get connected via our resources. Or sometimes it's a free and open access article that you can click very easily and get it freely if it says there's a free version from the publisher or in a repository. That sometimes works a little bit faster than connecting through our resources if it's already published freely somewhere else. It will also link you to the references of the paper, their references. So like references 50 would be the 50 references in this paper. 13,000 citations would be the citations that cited this original paper. So if you want to see who cited it since it was written, you can click on this link. But the other interesting thing I want to show you in Web of Science is this Analyze Results option. Again, this is something specific to Web of Science. And the way I think that you could use it that might be interesting or helpful to you is to look at a graphical representation of the results. So you might be interested to see which authors are using this data set. So if I choose authors, it can show you the author who's used this data set the most is this person here. It shows you some of the other top authors. And if you want to see the records, if you want to see the articles, you can click on each of the squares. You might be interested to know which institutions are using this the most. Harvard, University of California System, Johns Hopkins University. And then another good one would be the publication titles. If you're trying to decide what would be a good venue for publishing your research, you could look and see what are the top journals that people have published in on this topic. So you can conduct a normal search in here using your PICO elements just like you would in PubMed or Embase, but it has some additional features that really help you look at the landscape of the literature. And you may find some articles in here that weren't available in your other searches. Like any of our resources, if you have any questions, please reach out to your medical librarians and we are happy to help you.